Happy Sunday slash early Monday morning to everybody. Hope you all had a great weekend. This is the Sunday night market update video. I just wanted to talk about a couple of quick pairs and look at the general movement that we should be seeing happening here. So let's bring those up and look at them, starting with the euro dollar. We have had some pretty good runs in this euro dollar. Everyone, in the last video that I posted regarding this euro, we talked a little bit about how the pair had a nice run down back in July. July to about November was the high and low area. We saw that it was unable to break this 50% retracement that happened several times. Talked about this video several days ago. First attempt back here in November, second attempt same month, and the third attempt here in May. And now it is coming off this 50% level once again on the week chart and making its way down. Now the question is, what's going to happen with the euro? We see a couple of situations going on here. We've got kind of an immediate trend line right here where it is been running up this 4-hour trend, but I think that we'll have to watch it. I don't really know what I think this pair is going to be doing right now, but all we do know is that in the immediate it's coming down just a bit, and it looks like it's heading below our Dharma. So if we can get this thing to break somewhere below our low of Friday, that may be a good signal to take this thing down. But we've already seen a nice bounce off the red line and a continued downward movement, so that should be good. One thing that everybody needs to be super duper clear on is the week charts on several of these pairs. Pound dollar made a run at the 50% retracement, unable to break it, coming back down to the trend line here on the day chart. Lots of space to go, lots of 500 pips or so before it gets to that trend line. Lots of room to go there. Aussie yen, same thing, made a run at the 50%. It's coming off it just a little bit. It's got some space to go before making its way down. I'm a lot more bullish on the Australian dollar and bearish on the yen. So I think this one may have a little less retracement, a little more continued upward movement than maybe we would see on the euro dollar or the pound dollar. I think the Canadian should remain strong, the Aussie should remain strong, the yen will probably remain fairly weak. But as to what the euro against the US dollar and the pound against the US dollar is going to do is yet to be seen, and we need to kind of watch and see what happens there. But we see that this nice trend line here gives us plenty of movement to head back, and we see that it gave us a very nice turnaround here and an attempt at the 50%. So that's going to be a big theme on pretty much all of these pairs that have any major movements from July of last year to November, December, January, over that kind of four to six, 7 month period. We're seeing big retracements and everything's hitting these fib levels. So that's one key thing to watch. The next key thing to watch is that many of these pairs have broken upper levels on day charts and made pretty nice little comebacks. So very likely we're going to see some retests of several of these upper trend lines here on day charts. So watch these trend lines on your day charts. I've got a couple on this euro. I don't know where this one came from here. I've got a couple on this euro. We've got this trend line right here, kind of the overall movement, which gives us plenty of room before hitting that 600 pips or so. And then we've got the immediate trend line that we can see on the 4-hour chart, which the pair is actually sitting on. So I'd like to see it make a little bit of a break of that to really confirm that it can continue downward. But that will be an interesting pair to watch. I'm definitely keeping my eye on reversals on both the pound and the euro. You know, they've obviously made some pretty big downward movements, and I think I'm going to keep an eye on those pairs as far as continued downward movement. I think that will be crucial in this whole thing. So the continued downward movement on the euro dollar and the pound dollar will be probably my main focus. Euro yen, 4-hour trend line, just running up nicely. It's coming back to revisit that. But once again, same type of situation, making a run at the 50%. Got a little bit of room to go still, so this one could continue up nicely on us. But it's having trouble with this high back here in April. So it's really kind of sitting at this high. It made a little push up above it, and it's just right back at that. So we're going to kind of see what this euro yen does. When in doubt, go with the trend. And I think the trend is still, well, the trend is still up. So let's look and see if this thing can recharge back to this trend line a little bit before continuing back upward. So we'll watch for that continued upward movement after a possible dip down. And an interesting one is this euro pound. When we see that the euro dollar and pound dollar start to kind of move out of sync with each other, then we see that those two pairs can cause this pair to move in a very interesting way. So we'll see what this euro pound decides to do, but same type of situation. It's coming up, it's attempting this trend line right here. So we need to watch this. This could give us a bounce down, down to the lower channel, but a break above this could give us a very nice continuation upward. So a break above this trend line here could give us a very nice run up. And we see that the 4-hour stochastics are very much favoring something like that. And the 1 hours are, 4-hour, 1-hour stochastics are a little bit out of line, but that's okay. So anyways, kind of the sentiment, and what I want everybody to remember to focus on in the market here is we've had huge runs up on the euro dollar, the pound dollar, several of the yen pairs. There's going to need to be some retracement. I think the bigger retracement will probably happen in the euro dollar and the pound dollar, and a little less on the Aussie pairs and on the yen pairs. But it's time to start looking for some small turnarounds. Market sentiment, what everybody's feeling, what the news is saying, what's being talked about is overall we feel that the economy is getting better, yet everybody's a little shell-shocked and a little bit scared about what has happened. So the economy is making an interesting recovery. People are not jumping back on spending money, getting credit, buying, confidence in their jobs. They're more in the direction of maybe things are getting better. They're definitely better than they were several months ago, but I'm going to save money. I'm not going to spend quite as much, and I'm kind of afraid if I'm going to have a job or not. So that's kind of just what I've been picking up in the news and reading about and everything. Not to mention we saw several interest rate announcements happen last week. Nothing went changed. It was all left basically as it was. I don't think we had a single changed interest rate last week, and we had some pretty negative numbers on non-farm payroll, but we're slowly getting less negative. So I think the dollar is going to probably start giving us a little bit of a run. So let's keep an eye on some potential dollar pairs, strength in dollar, and let's also watch this pound dollar. This is one level I've been watching right here. As it breaks this daily pivot, it's just sitting on this daily pivot right here, about the 59.20 area. A break below that should give us a nice movement down. So keep an eye on that, everybody. Good luck on your trading, and we will see you on the upcoming webinars and the chats this week. Thank you, guys.